aluminum construction, little corrugated aluminum right here, and little glass windows. And inside, look at this. That's a motorcycle. Look, a CB200T. That's a Honda. Let's pop the back and have a closer look. Hey, Steve Mignani here doing the junkyard crawl at Berniston Auto Wrecking in Bernardston, Massachusetts, with a 1967 Chevy C10 pickup truck. Now, this is the styling cycle that most people say really made Chevy pickup trucks popular with car buyers. These were made from 67 through 1972, but 67 was the only year they did not have marker lamps on the front or rear fenders. And 67 and 68 are also the 2 years where the design of the front of the hood had more of an angular design to it than the more vertical situation used in 68 or 69, 70, 71, and 72. But again, this one here has the bright grille work and Argent insert of a CST custom sport truck, CST right here on the driver's side door. So this was kind of the Cadillac, if you will, of Chevy pickup trucks. Now this is an 8-foot bed. This is the long bed, of which there were 165,973 built, compared to 43,940 short beds with the style side body. So these long beds outsold the short beds 4-to-1. And you got to remember that people buy pickup trucks for style, but mostly for utility. The bigger the bed, the more useful the truck is. Under the hood on this one, and again, part of that CST is the chrome front bumper. That would be painted on a lesser truck, but again, CST was the big deal in 67. Okay, this has a 6-cylinder engine and very austere manual brakes, and something we see here for the first time in 67 is the dual circuit master cylinder. Those two little domes on top are part of the separated front and rear brake circuits. 1966, that would be a single pot, as it were, but again, 67, first year for that on all domestic vehicles. A six banger in place, probably a 250 six-cylinder Chevy. Pushrod engine, very basic, an evolution of the Stovbolt 6, but again, this came along in 1963 or 4 to replace the old 235 Stovbolt. 250 cubes, looks like a manual transmission. We'll know more about that when we go inside. But something kind of neat too for 1967, this generation of Chevy trucks, the inner fenders are round, almost like a bowl, if you will. The point of that was that on the other side of that, it was self-cleaning, and GM actually touted the fact that as the truck went down the road, water would spray up and self-clean that smooth bowl-like inner fender. Whereas previous generations had boxy, flatter areas, lots of nooks and crannies for rust and sand and soil to accumulate. But again, these were self-cleaning, and that's how Chevrolet described them. Of course, there was a GMC cousin to this. We'll get to that in a second, too. The weird thing I see on this thing, these hubcaps are from somewhere else. These are Ford pickup truck hubcaps, or passenger car hubcaps, actually. Even a base 68 Mustang would wear that same hubcap, but they fit the same nub. But keep in mind, behind that is going to be a six-lug wheel, which would be something that Chevrolet used on their half-tonners up through 1971 when front disc brakes and five-lug wheels took over. But again, CST, custom sport special, custom sport truck, excuse me. And of course, dome lights up top, or cab lights added. These are not Chevrolet items, but you know, they kind of look like they're from another application. They're kind of curved, but they look cool. Glass lenses, that's kind of a cool thing. Make it look like a big rig, part of kind of the thing to do with your pickup truck if you want to pretend you're driving a Peterbilt or a Kenworth, put lights on a roof. It does have the optional West Coast mirrors, which were a factory option right there, a little bit rotten away, but inside, there it is. CST means bucket seats. And if you're used to a Corvette bucket seat, these are a little different. They are separate, left and right. The center is an armrest that flips up or down. These are true buckets in this thing. And the weird thing about this, if we take a look at the steering column, 3-speed manual on the column, but it has the CST pedal dress-up. Look at the chrome trim, like a GTO or an SS396, but that's part of the CST, even with the 3-speed on the column, which is kind of a strange contrast in existence. Now, here's the trim tag, or the VIN, whatever you want to call it, right here. And we can learn about this truck. We see CE147T. C is a two-wheel drive. E is a V8 truck. More on that in a second. One is a half ton. Four is the pickup truck. Seven is 1967. T is Terrytown, New York assembly. So that second digit right there, that E, if this was really a six-cylinder truck, that would be an S. So this is a six-cylinder swap into what was born a V8 pickup truck. This would have had either a 283 or a 327 or potentially a 396, but more than likely probably the 283 or the 327. So it wasn't uncommon in the 1970s as gasoline prices started to go through the roof. people take this V8 out, put a six-cylinder in, and so this truck is a custom sport truck with a six-cylinder swap, where it used to have a V8. You can learn a lot from the VIN. Never assume anything until you check the VIN. This does have a cap, an aluminum cap in place, but something kind of cool. This is, again, the GMC cousin, 1967, all new. Of course, GMC had four headlights versus two on Chevrolet. Very similar in its overall design, of course. Basically the same truck. And you see we have it here. It says here, for your greater convenience and safety, the following items are standard equipment on all GMC light duty models. And you can say the same for Chevy, by the way. Seat belts with push button buckles, safety arm rests, passenger car door locks, safety door latches and hinges, soft low profile window control knobs, yielding smooth contoured door and window regular handles for safety in a crash, padded instrument panel and sun visors, again, so you don't cut yourself up in a crash, reduced glare instrument panel, horn button and windshield wiper arms and blades, so they don't blind you in the sun and you don't crash into things you can't see, thick laminate windshield, dual speed windshield wipers and washer, two outside rear view mirrors, four-way hazard warning flasher, backup lights, parking lamps that illuminate with the headlamps and side reflectors, lane change feature in directional system control, dual master cylinder brake system with warning light and corrosion resistant brake lines. And speaking of the bucket seats, yes, even GMC had them. We can see that red vehicle right there. That is the custom interior, as we see on this CST Chevrolet. The others, of course, are the deluxe, the custom, and the super custom, which have bench, whereas the buckets are an option. And the buckets were optional on any cab. You could pay extra, but they came standard with the CST, which, of course, included this little logo right here. Now, again, this is an 8.5-foot bed. It has the coil spring rear suspension of a half tonner. There was an optional leaf spring suspension in GMC land and probably for Chevy too. But anyway, this is the aluminum cap, and these would become fiberglass as you get into the 1970s. But this might be the original cap to this truck. Aluminum construction, little corrugated aluminum right here, and little glass windows. And inside, look at this. That's a motorcycle. Look, a CB200T. That's a Honda. Let's pop the back and have a closer look. You know, you never know what you're going to find in the junkyard. And you always look inside every vehicle. Ah, okay, this tree is in the way. But yeah, that's a CB200T. Very original. And again, the 200T. T means touring. Has a different exhaust system. Comes down a little lower than the upper on the CB200. These are made from 73 through 76, and that's a very clean Japanese motorcycle right there. I wonder if the yard even knows it's here. I'll have to bring this up to Dale. But other details that were new for 67 were the one-hand tailgate, which replaced the more awkward stuff in 66. So again, 1967, a totally new design for Chevrolet pickup trucks. And these were made, again, from 67 through 1972. And the vast majority were long beds. But again, this thing has two things going for it. It's a half ton, two-wheel drive, but it's a long bed. But with that said, there's a company called Brothers that will sell you a short bed conversion kit. Basically, they sell you a template with a girder, cut your frame, take about a foot out of it, put this template and this structure back in there, bolt and weld that thing in, and voila, you've got a short wheelbase. But what about the bed? Well, lots of companies sell reproduction short beds, all brand new metal. So you can actually take a long bed and turn it into a short bed and get the Holy Trinity. Short bed, two-wheel drive, half ton, and really take it home. But again, this is a first year for this generation of Chevy pickup truck. CST with a six-cylinder swap. That's really kind of puzzling. But again, with that said, it has an E in the VIN, not an S for six. This is a V8 truck when it was born, unless it's a factory error, which I kind of doubt. Because all along the way, people registering this truck with the E as a V8 would have probably caught, hey, that's not a V8, that's a six. This was swapped in almost certainly at some point along the line. But if you like this video, be sure to subscribe to the Steve Maggs YouTube channel and ring the bell so that you're aware of new videos as they happen, which is every single day. And keep in mind, we've got about 400 videos in the Junkyard Crawl series that are in the channel playlist. You can check them out and watch them for free right now if you want. We'll come back tomorrow morning with the next Junkyard Crawl video.